to come in here this morning for various reasons, one of which was the barricading of the route to KICC. But I must thank the organizers for having brought it to KICC, because if it was a state house, Mr. President, it would even have been a little harder. The reason is simple. Our country is at a crossroads. My colleague, Honorable Kimani Ichung'wah, has highlighted that we, both of you, asked us to undertake the process of NADCO following the 2023 enactment of the finance bill and the riots that place, where we lost people, 75 of them, property was destroyed, and the country was in a state of a shock. We undertook that responsibility with gusto, and we were very open-minded. As we were in Kenya, our number one topic was the high cost of living. But Kimani and the team in Kenya Kwanza convinced us that it was the government's responsibility, and the position had nothing to do with discussing the high cost of living. I hope that in the light of recent developments, I think Kimani would have revised that thought. Because again, 2024, Finance Act, and the riots, and again, we have lost one young Kenyans. This time they came in the form of Gen Z, but they are Kenyans. They have a right to belong. In fact, they are carrying the national flags. They have done it better than we did. And some personnel got killed. Mr. President, I want to urge that we look at our country afresh. There's no way we can wish away the Gen Z revolution. And if we were to begin to be honest with ourselves, perhaps we need not to go back to Obama's, because during the presentations, Kimani and Cheruiyot may remember, and Wandayi was deputizing me, there are a lot of Kenyans wanted us to open this space. The space has been opened by Gen Z. I wish we had moved with speed. It has taken inordinate delay to get where we are today, to get the first product out of NADCO. And I'm not so sure, my friend, whether it is expected of us to even fast track the other eight. They have to be just opposed to the reality of the country and this new revolt. If you're not capable of us, get thrown out by the agencies, because they say, we've come of age. You say that we are leaders of tomorrow, we are leaders now. We can't wish them away. Therefore, I want to urge that we now look at the whole thing. For example, we have now set up a process of meeting new commissioners. We made it very clear that both you, Mr. President, Mr. Raila Odinga, the Prime Minister, will have to agree on, perhaps most importantly, on who becomes the chair of the new IT. That principle of consultation was inbuilt, and I thank my colleagues, because we didn't have to struggle much to agree. But now is the time. The country is at a crossroads. Can we, for beginning, even in order to bring the country to normalcy, can you, Mr. President, order the Inspector General of Police, if he doesn't resign, can he remove the police from the streets? Can the army get out of our streets and back to the barracks? I thank you.